I guess I'm just trying to figure it out. I've just always known about him. He's just always been a part of this community. He's got such a great reputation. When I was ready to go and see somebody about preventative Botox care, I never really had to research who I wanted to see. I always knew that that was going to be Dr. Blackledge.
As I've said before, he's a wonderful human being, number one, and I know he's going to take care of me. And I just don't worry. I don't worry. And there's a lot of apprehension, I think, that goes with plastic surgery. And you just don't have that with him.
Oh, every time I see him, he's, "You're so pretty, you're so pretty." And I'm like, "Well, it's because of you." Like, the whole reason I feel so pretty is because of what, you know, he's done for me. I feel like this always should have been my face, and Dr. Blackledge just helped me reveal it.
I think that what sets us apart is my passion. I think my passion for faces is unrivaled. And I think that when your passion is that driven, then it starts to take care of everything else. It's what starts to set us apart as far as the results that we achieve, looking natural, looking unoperated on. And I think that the other thing that happens is that sets us apart is our patients are drawn to us because there's a family atmosphere here. Patients know us on a first name basis. They have our cell phones, making house calls. Those kinds of things, the process, I tell everybody, being from a small town, I can outwork anybody. And that's what makes us the best, is a personalized approach that is unrivaled. I have no doubt about that, because I love what I do, but I love taking care of patients and seeing an end result that patients are so excited about.
He's just fun to be around and makes the whole experience better.
Don't be scared to come in. Like I said previously, I wish I had called sooner. I just didn't really know what to expect. It can be a little intimidating to come into a plastic surgeon's office, but this is why they're here. They're happy to have you and happy to help you with whatever you need.
It has definitely made me more confident and feel better about myself and feel younger. And, you know, the neck is the first to go. My mother always told me that, and it really is true. And it had gone, and it was just, you know, I needed to do it, and I kept putting it off. I'm so glad I went ahead and did it. Wish I'd done it a couple of years ago, actually.
He just makes you laugh, you know. He just brightens your day and is always very concerned with anything that you have concerns about and wants to ease you of any of those concerns.
You know, I think the most beautiful facelifts are the facelifts. It's not what you take away, but it's what you leave behind. Because everybody comes in and they say, "Adair, I just want all of this gone." And I say, you know what? A beautiful facelift is actually more about what we're going to leave behind. So let's talk about what we're going to leave. We're going to leave your character. We're going to leave the things that make you look like you. We're just going to take you back to a version of you from 10 to 15 years ago. And so to me, facelifts should be subtle. They should be natural, never an operated look. And more than anything, it should still be you. It should say, "This is who I am," just a younger, fresher, more natural look.
I thought I wanted to come in and have Botox. And they, of course, happily took my appointment. But we go in his office and you sit down and you have a consultation with him. You talk through with him what you're looking for. And of course, he hears you. But then at the same time, you don't even realize he's doing it. He's talking to you and he's watching your facial expressions and he's watching how your face moves and how it doesn't move and where he wants it to go after he finishes hearing your needs. And then, like I said, he meets you in the middle. You're not looking in the mirror talking to yourself all day, so you don't really know what your face is doing or not doing. And so you don't even realize he's working while he's working.
The first thing I do is I talk to the patient, because it's a lot about what, how their face looks when they're moving. And so I get them to talk. I really like to get them to laugh. We will talk, and the patients usually don't even realize that I'm getting them to tell a story that requires them to laugh, because when I see them laugh, then everything else changes as well. I want them to have expression. The day of having that injected look where you have no expression is over, hopefully. And so I love to see patients, how their faces move. I also, when I look at a patient, I'm usually thinking not just about their face, I'm usually thinking about their makeup colors. I think a lot about brows, because brows, eyebrows shape they shape the face and they frame the eyes. And so I'm usually talking to them not just about their Botox injections, but hey, let's do a little something different with your brows. I'm usually also, patients laugh because the first thing they ask me is, Adair, what do you think about my hair color? And I say, well, this is what I think. You know, I think that we could go a little bit lighter or a little bit darker or more highlights. And so that's usually what I'm thinking. It's not so much about the actual injection, but how the injection fits their face.
You know, I trust him completely. You know, everything he's ever done, I've never seen it look bad. I love my results, so I just show everyone my before and after, and I'm like, look what he did for me, and look what he could do for you.
Professionally, he's exactly what you want, and the kind of person that's gonna be helping me maintain what my exterior looks like, hopefully for decades and decades here on out. Very kind, very patient. Here's my cell phone number. Call me if you have a problem.
Well, it's amazing that he will come to your house. I mean, who hears of doctors making house calls anymore? I certainly don't. The entire thing was a nice experience. My friends couldn't believe that I didn't hurt. I never took a pain pill. And he's just like a wonderful friend.
I think it's the only way to do what I do. I think that a hands-on approach requires not just being a patient's physician, but being their confidant. And I think that that requires being able to make a house call at 2 a.m. Because you know what? A lot of these patients, I'm amazed at how many of these patients have medical background. They may be physicians. They may be physicians' wives or nurses or in the medical field, but yet they've never had a facelift. You know, so they may have worked for an orthopedic surgeon, but they don't know what's normal. They don't know what's normal swelling, what's bruising. And so they're relying on me not just to get them to the goal of looking natural, but to get them through the goal. And that's a process. I mean, I love to give my cell phone out to patients because immediately you can see that there's this breath of trust that they build in you, and they think, okay, if I need a deer, I can get in touch with them. And so that's, it's not a different way. I think it's the only way of doing my own, I love to do my own injections because yes, I could teach somebody else, but what I would teach them is the technique. You can never teach artistry. You cannot teach artistry. It's something that you see and that you relate in a technique. I can teach my technique of injectables and I can teach my technique of skincare, but I can't teach what I see and translate into a technique.